श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम ओम 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 श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्रीराम जय राम जय जय राम हरिओम एवरीबडी। इन स्पाइट ऑफ पापा'स हैमरिंग रेगुलरली नाउ वी हैव बीन वाचिंग बट व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इज टू फील हिज कंपेनियनशिप नॉट द कंपेनियनशिप ऑफ एनीबडी हु इज आउटसाइड अस Companionship of one who is always with us, about whom we are not aware. So many people, you know, this doubt comes to all of us. Why, in spite of it, we are not in a position to do it? The only answer is, have we applied our mind seriously to it? Nowadays, you know, every word of his must be probed deep, deep. At the superficial level, we cannot understand. We have been hearing, we will be sharing with others. So, yesterday, and you don't know whether it was here or in the rest of the time, periodical solitude, periodical retreat, periodical cutoff is necessary. We don't say it the days together or months together. At least in a day, at least we should have some time allotted to us. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, where we are totally free from all our mundane bindings, you know. And then have a dialogue with him. My master says you are within. I believe. But for enabling me to become a reality, what all I should do, I don't know. You give some instruction, but even then I understand it only literally, you know. what it stands for, I am unable to understand. When I go to the dictionary, it gives me some meaning. But the real meaning can come only when I do some manana, which I forget. So the only way is to somehow do the manana. And manana means, you know, you are there. We know that you are there. But why don't you make us aware of your presence? So during our pause moment, during our sattvic mood, whenever we get a leisure, we try to develop this dialogue with him. There is no other way, there is no shortcut. You lost your net connection, trying to reconnect. Coming. So today, when we were with this background, you know, when we were coming from Dhamma building, suddenly the prompting came to take God experience. And the page, you know, again it talks about his experience. Probably we might be able to remind ourselves. The mind is going out during meditation because it still has attraction for external things. External things means not merely the sense objects. Even external things which we do under the banner of spirituality. Day for yesterday, Swami Chidanji Maharaj said, connect yourself with him. Somehow you connect, you know. He said, not necessarily through this method, but connect yourself. Ramdas was virtually in that wonderful state of mind, dead to the world. The world never existed for him, so to say. His eyes were only half open because he had no desire to see anything. He had no anxiety. The mind was attuned to Ramnam, and so when he sat for meditation after a year's yatra, there was no struggle. Many sit for meditation and find that the mind is distracted. They are unable to quell the waves of the mind. They cannot maintain inner awareness for long. Ramdas had no such struggle at all because he was already dead to the world. The mind did not wander here and there. He had no attachment or longing for the objects of life. So what is the clue? Hidden hint, you know, contentment. Am I free from wants? During our past moments, you know, we can sit and ask for ourselves these questions. We are asking anything from others, you know. We are not asking to him. So we are asking him, do you feel make me contented? Still some craving comes, you know. Why don't you, so long as that craving is there, I know I cannot concentrate on you. Because naturally the whole attention will be to satisfy that craving, satisfy that desire. So make me to feel contented. Zero craving. Zero desire. Something like that, you know, whatever one can pray. Then only we will be able to quell the waves of the mind. So in Kadri cave, mind dissolved the moment he sat down for meditation. Meditation also we feel, you know, the sitting in one posture. All these things occupy our mind. The main thing is, it is a mental exercise through which we are trying to move toward the core of our being, in whatever form it is there. In Papa's case, the meditation was to dwell on the attributes. And the meditation also got graduated, no? To different levels. and finally it ends where the thought is totally absent. When Kadri gave, his mind dissolved the moment he sat down. This was a new experience when he lost completely the body consciousness and became illumined within and united with the divine. Ramdas's body underwent many hardships in unfavorable conditions, but they never affected him. In Jhansi, you know, when he was walking, he was in rags, blisters, legs swollen. And somebody said, you know, somebody wants you to go to the shop. And he went there, he was immediately offered a seat. He did not sit on the seat. But that trip God arranges so that he needs something. He did not ask. Next moment, what is there? He is not, no anxiety, he says, you know. When am I going to get that state? You know, when I read this, I must immediately ask myself. Anxiety at the superficial level is okay for vyavahar. But anxiety at the deep level, no. Because he decides, you know. Why should there be anxiety? And there he was there for 1.5 months. Okay, 1.5 months he lived. Or 1 month he lived. And what did he choose later? Again, solitude. So that he should not be carried away by the senses again when the basic needs were met with, like dress or warm clothing, food, timely food, medication, so on and so forth, because they were all full of love. So finally, when he said, I want to go, he chose this solitude, where everything is denied again. So we take it that unless and until we devise some method to check whether the degree of contentment, whether it stays in positives and negative, adverse and other times. When somebody is giving, okay. At the same time, to ensure that when it is not given, that is also okay. That state. We are finding it difficult because we are hearing it, praising ourselves in the comfort zones. That is the greatest difficulty. Ramdas's body underwent many hardships in unfavorable condition, but they were never affected him because he was mostly oblivious of the body. He would sit anywhere, rest anywhere. Sometimes he had starved. He could now remember how he was moving from place to place. It was really a strange state. When Ramdas was in Rishikesh, he met many sadhus living in kutis. When the bell rang, we used to go together to the anakshetra for bhiksha. One elderly man asked Ramdas, how did you get this joy? Papa, God gave him. It's a simple answer. But placing ourselves, we will immediately say, I have done this, I have done that, no? From 1920 onwards, I will take my history. But here a simple word, God gave him. How is it he does not give us? What sadhana did you do? Ramdas. Sadhu, we are also doing it. We do not get this joy. When did you get this joy? Only a year ago, he was filled with joy. How was it caused? God caused it. That was the language in which Ramdas spoke to them. And today also he can only say, it is all by God's will. Then another sannyasi said, I have been here for 30 years. Every day I bathe in the Ganges, practice meditation, take my bhiksha from the nakshatra. The bad food causes indigestion and other troubles. I often go to the hospital, take medicine, and the mind is never at rest. I am running about in this way. 30 years have elapsed. I have achieved nothing. I have left my home, wife, children. I have burned my boats, and the future is dark. If any sadhu in one of the kuti dies, when the others come to know of it, they would say, he is saved. He has not died. He was undergoing so much suffering. That is now over. In that manner, they would congratulate him on his death, which had put an end to the miseries. There are many to whom death is a merciful release. They think if one goes to the four dhamma, Badri, Rameshwar, Dwarka, Jagannath Puri, and visit the shrines there, one will attain mukti. That is the belief. One of the sadhus was too old to go on a pilgrimage any longer. He had installed an image of Badri Narayana and was worshipping. He said, I had been to Badri Narayana 10 times and I got nothing. I am spending my time now in worshipping the image. His back was bent with age. Ramdas met innumerable sadhus during his tours. So here we have to replace ourselves in the place of sadhus. And instead of kudis, we can say, we have been doing Ramnam for years and years together. We have been meeting saints, we have been doing bhajan, we have been reading some books, we have been doing this and that, but we feel we are there wherever we are. Then only this reading will help us. Because all the answers Papa gave, the simple answer is that we should know that all these things were done by him because he facilitated us, motivated us, made us to do that. That truth should get imprinted in us. That is the message from this. He says, you know, I've been here for 30 years, every day I bathe in Ganges, practice meditation, take my bhiksha from the Anakshatra. 30 years have elapsed and I have achieved nothing. The language used to, it was all by God's way, God's way. There should be only one answer from us always. Glory to him for facilitating everything for us. Swami Dayanandji Maharaj, that prayer, thy glory. The last word, in all my capacities, in all my capabilities, make me to see thy glory. Even in the act of seeing, hearing, even in the act of thinking, thy glory, thy glory, thy glory, thy glory. Somehow we have to do something. Time is running fast. Ramdas met innumerable saints during his tours. They were all grumbling that they had achieved nothing. How is it God singled Ramdas out and granted him his grace? It was grace, grace, and nothing but grace. In his earlier life, there was nothing remarkable about his devotion to God. That means prior to 1922. He lived like an ordinary man of the world without any keen longing or devotion for God. At one period of his life, he was even a skeptic. He had read some books written by scientists of the West. They tried to prove that there was no God and that God was a figment of the imagination of the people who were mentally weak or unbalanced. So when he read a book called Evolution of the Idea of God by a scientist who sought to prove by argument that there was no God, it undermined his faith in God. But later he came in contact with the teachings of Sri Ramakrishna, Swami Vivekananda, Swami Ramtirtha. Then he regained the lost faith. 2 or 3 years before Ramdas left Mangalore on his wandering life, he was attracted greatly by Swami Ramtirtha's work. He was talking only about him to friends. He learned by heart portions from his speeches and saying. He was also courting the company of saints and sadhus attending Harikatha performances. He was thus drawn to the life of devotion to God. Later he was caught in the grip of sadhana of repeating God's name day and night. Sense pleasures lost all glamour for him. He was praying for God madness. God made him ask for it and he granted it. God made him ask for it, he granted it. Even the yearning, you know, even the aspiration, even the desire, even the intensity, it's all attributed not to the individual but to him. He was praying for God madness. God made him ask for it and God granted it. In that state he gave up everything of the world, went away regardless of consequences. He had no idea of what was in store for him. He had no plans when he left Bangalore, traveled far and wide. During this period, Ramdas was going from place to place by railway train without tickets. Some people object to this mode of travel. Is it not against railway rules, against moral principles? Ramdas did not know moral proprieties. Do you know why he traveled without ticket? Sadhus who were escorting him took him to the station. He was sitting with them in the train. They had no tickets. Come on, come on, they would say and make him sit by their side in the railway compartment. The ticket collector would come and say, get down, get down. No disappointment was felt by Ramdas. He had no program to reach any he had no program to reach any place at any particular time. To get into the train, get out of the train. No place, you know, he will say, no, I have to reach a particular time. How was he able to get over the anxiety? He was free from planning, you know. If there is a train or plane at 7:30 or 8 o'clock, we will be, you know, excited from 6 o'clock or so. I have to go, have I arranged whether the auto will come, whether the taxi will come. So many. Just watch. No disappointment was felt by Ramdas. He had no program to reach any place at any particular time. 2 days or 20 days, it did not matter. He was quite free from where, station, road, anywhere. He was absorbed in the repetition of Ramdas. 2 years ago, a friend came here. He was in the railway service and was devoted to us. Ramdas had met him in Punjab. He said, Papa, my conscience pricks me that you travel in the railway trains 1 or 2 years without tickets. That means you owe the railway company some money. I feel like paying the company and freeing you from the obligation. Can you find out how much it may come? Ramdas said, he has not at all any idea of it. I am prepared to pay whatever it is, he said. He was an honest man who had at one time held a high executive post in railways and also had plenty of money. He was ready to pay any amount to the railway company on behalf of Ramdas. Then Ramdas put in the question. If you are going to reimburse the amount, it means that Ramdas was wrong in having travelled in that manner. You have to accept that and then make the payment. He replied, no, you were not wrong. God made him pay it. No. I felt the money might be paid. Ramdas said, all right, you may pay it, but Ramdas does not know how much. Then the friend abandoned the idea of payment. Ramdas was not at all conscious that he did anything wrong. He was moving about like one completely free from all obligations. He never thought of cheating the company. In that spirit he wandered. Now Ramdas does not go without a ticket. When we read this, you know, so many things, you know, we have to stop and ponder over. When he was completely under the control of God, where are the rights and wrongs? And at the same time, when the friend suggested, Papa also took it was God who was proposing it. So like a child, he placed before him. At that time, Ramdas did not have any idea. But if you are reimbursing it, that means, you know, Ramdas may have committed wrong. If you see, if it is so, okay, do it, no? Papa did not say that it is wrong on your part to suggest like that. You see the method. At every point of time, this consciousness is there. There is no rights and wrongs. From the individual level, we have got rights and wrongs. That is what we knowingly or unknowingly try to apply whenever we are placed in such circumstances. So the gentleman who was working honestly, an upright man, was a devotee of Papa. He felt he should reimburse. You know? There is no self-interest involved. Because he was there in the railway company, and railway is able to exist because of the collections. That is how God gave him that idea. So that is why they have appointed ticket collectors, railway police, protection force, to ensure that no ticketless traveler is allowed. So with that background, he started. So he was not wrong. Papa did not belittle him, did not criticize him. He only praised. If you are going to reimburse the amount, it means Ramdas was having in mind in having traveled in that manner. Ramdas was wrong in having traveled. You have to accept that and then make the payment. Suddenly he said, no, you were not wrong. I felt the money might be paid. All right, you may pay it. But Ramdas does not know how much. Teaches us, you know, the approach. Your rights and wrongs are completely not out there. He is not justifying. At that time, when Sadhu Ram asked him to get in, he got in. The TT comes and says, you cannot travel, he gets out. Every time this is what is happening. No? And he also did not know no particular program to reach any place at any particular time. So this constant God remembrance, constant companionship, this is the theme he wants to, rings always throughout his book. So as sadhaks, aspirants, we have to take note of this. And we have to keep on praying to him. No? In spite of hearing this for umpteen number of times, we are still there where we are. We have not been able to implement, actualize, put it in our life. That is why we still feel that we are there where we are. Even that feeling also comes because you are there. So why don't you remove that feeling? And whatever is necessary to remove the feeling, why don't you please facilitate? And about this, he also answers. He was talking about the flute. Papa says, if you empty yourself completely, you create something like a vacuum within yourself, then you are really full. You are most useful. A fruit, unless it is empty, is of no use. It must be hollow. Otherwise, it will not produce any music. Such emptiness, love, is called Tao. The question, somebody makes the fruit empty, it cannot become empty by itself. Papa admitted, that somebody is yourself. Question, then ego comes, Papa. Papa, you must empty yourself of the ego and then the fruit prayer will take you out. I am nothing, you are everything, that is the way to empty yourself. We pose we are something. There lies all the trouble. We pose we are something. there lies all the trouble. Feel that you are nothing, then you will become everything. If you feel that you are something, then you are nothing. So keep on thinking about it. So this also, this particular episode, you know, of the dialogue with the sadhus we have been doing. So any activity, if it is not dedicated to God, it will not serve any purpose. Outwardly people may say so many things, but inwardly we will feel we are there where we are. Because only we know whether we have dedicated everything to Him. Nobody else will know. The truth is that because of Him only we exist. So Ram Nam chanting should enable us to somehow understand and realize that He is within us. So you have to zero to this, you know. Ram Nam chanting should enable us to know that He is within us and He is making us to do everything. So while we do the chanting, a part of the mind should keep on praying for this. I've been doing Ram Nam for now decades now, but still that feeling has not come. I have faith in the words, I have read your books. But it is you who is now making me to do that reality I have not realized. I have heard, I have understood. I repeat it. But the blunt truth is I have not yet realized. This should be our prayer now. And one day He will definitely hear our prayer and make us to feel His closeness first. So we start consulting Him, we start talking to Him, we start observing His hand, His finger and everything, which comes out in the form of contentment, the form of free from anxiety, in the form of equanimity, you know. All these values will start coming one by one, one by one. These are the litmus tests through which we know that we are moving nearer to Him, nearer to Him, nearer to Him. That is why Papa said, you know, outer activity should be compatible with inner aspiration. Outer activities should be compatible with inner aspiration. So me to we, a value-based life, a simple life, pure life. Even value-based life, we may say outer people may recognize that we are value. To us, we know how far we are value-based. Whether the purity is there, free from cravings, infatuations, desires. Whether we want anything, that would be better. Whether the wanting is there in anything. So constantly Papa is directing us towards all these teachings so that, you know, we will do some serious introverted inquiry and find out and then pray to him from the bottom of the heart for facilitating us, enabling us to live up to what we are expected of. So that is the take-home message for today. Tomorrow for a change we will have 1 hour, 30-40 minutes bhajan. And the bhajan is, you know, it is not merely hearing a song set to certain tunes, but the bhajan is to quieten our mind. And when the mind gets quietened, it enables us to have some free access towards Him, the one who is facilitating me to hear. I am unable to feel the presence because of the so many things the mind says. So, Ramnam Chadri with the devotional fervor, Bhajan Chadri with the devotional fervor, enables the mind to quieten, and it provides a conducive atmosphere for us to have some access towards His presence. And especially suppose we travel with the team, you know, it gives a boost. Otherwise the mind is likely to be carried away by the tune, the raga. No doubt, raga is also given by God only, but we hardly recognize that raga has been given by God for enabling us to quieten the mind, for enabling us to dwell on Gartha, for enabling us to dwell on the glories of the God. And like that, you know, that we used to enjoy a program and then go away. So tomorrow, with all these background, we will have a sadhana-oriented bhajan program. Hari Om. Om Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Om Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Om Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Om Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Hari Om to everybody.